Good morning, students. Today we are going to understand part 1 of the chapter Deep Water of your book Flamingo by William Douglas. Okay, so we will be studying in part 1 what summary and message and theme of the chapter Deep Water. Deep Water, William Orville Douglas, 1898-1980, means he is the writer, author of the chapter, and this chapter Deep Water story. This story has been taken out from his autobiography of Man and Mountains. Fine. From there we have taken out this chapter. So William Orville Douglas, 1898, born in 1898 and died in 1980, was an American jurist and politician who served as an Associate Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States. Nominated by President Franklin D. Roosevelt, Douglas was confirmed at the age of 40 as one of the youngest justices appointed to the Supreme Court. His term lasted 36 years and 209 days. Okay, and he retired at the age 75. Is the longest term in the history of the Supreme Court. The theme of the chapter Deep Water. Actually, what is the theme? And yes, the title is appropriate and apt. Why? Because when William Douglas met two incidents in his life, he developed an aversion with water, aquaphobia. So now we will see theme. That author William Douglas talks about his fear of water and how he finally overcame it. So whatever he experienced, he has narrated in his biography. He narrates an autobiographical incident, his autobiography, okay, that occurred when he was 10 or 11 years old and almost drowned in a YMCA swimming pool. As a result, he developed a fear of water, which he was able to conquer after several years by sheer determination. Okay, so the message of the chapter, the story Deep Water. The story says what? The story Deep Water tells us how the writer overcame his fear of water and learned swimming through sheer determination and willpower. Means, two incidents happened at a very early age. One incident happened when he was 3 or 4 years old, and second incident when he was 10 or 11 years old. Okay, he had developed a terror of water since childhood. William Douglas was able to overcome his fear by sheer determination. So he had developed a terror of water since childhood, but he was able to overcome his fear by sheer determination. Okay, we will see in the chapter that how much determined he was. The message conveyed by this story is that it is not death, but the fear of death. What is the fear of death? That creates terror in our mind, so that fear needs to be shaken off. Why? Because it creates deep inroads on us. In our minds. Also, any fears can be conquered if we try hard enough. Yes, students, it is right. If you have any fear, if you would like to achieve your target, any obstacle, you can conquer any obstacle, any fear, if you try hard enough for that. Okay, now we will see summary of the chapter. Deep Water is about the writer's journey of overcoming the fear of water, okay, which is deeply rooted in him since childhood. The author started fearing water since the age of 4. Actually, what happened when author was in the age of 3 or 4 years old, it starts when he was visiting. The fear, or you can say aversion with water, starts when he was visiting California with his father. He visits a beach where a wave knocks him down and sweeps over him. This terrifies the author. Why? Because actually what happens over there, he visits a beach where a wave knocks down knocks him down and sweeps over him. This terrifies the author. Although the father laughs at his knowing, it was no danger because father knew very well. Father knew very well that waves knock his son down and swept over him. But he knew that it was no danger, okay? However, this experience, his breath was gone. Whose breath? Douglas' breath was gone because he was very small. He was frightened, okay? But and after that incident, there was a terror, okay? There was a terror in his heart, okay? However, this experience terrifies him and develops a fear of water. Okay, then the second incident happened when he tried to swim in a pool at the YMCA in Yakima. Okay, in Yakima River and Yakima City. But when he tried to swim over there, okay, then what happened? When the author is 11 years old, he experiences another incident which escalates his fear. Why? Means you can say increase more fear, jada fear usko hone laga. Kaise hone laga? Because over there one incident happened. Ek incident ho jata hai. Because you all know very well when he was 3 or 4 years old. Jab wo 3 or 4 years old tha, one incident happened when he was enjoying beach in California. Okay, and waves knocked him down. Okay, and he was buried in water. That incident was in his mind, and the second incident happened at the age of 11 years, and he told the second incident misadventure. Why misadventure? Because when he was trying to swim, when he was trying to copy other boys how to swim, the incident happened. Why? Listen, he is at a swimming pool in Yakima trying to learn swimming. On one fine day, what happened? William Douglas went to the pool when no one else was there. He was waiting for other boys to come. The place was quiet, okay? The water was still and the tile bottom was as white and clean as a bathtub, okay? And suddenly what happened when he was waiting for other boys to come? He had not been there, means swimming pool, long when he came a big bruiser of a boy. Probably 18 years old. एक जो bully boy bully आता वहाँ पे एक लड़का आता है probably 18 years old decides to pull a dangerous prank. He decides to pull a dangerous prank. He would like to make fun of William Douglas. Okay, and over there what happened that he asked him. Ha, he yelled. Ha, skinny means 18 years old boy. 18 years old boy shouted at William Douglas, "Hi skinny, how would you like to be ducked?" And he pushes him in the deep end of the pool, which frightens the author. Actually, beta, swimming pool at YMCA was deep, 9 feet deep at one end. At one end it was 2 or 3 feet deep and the other end 9 feet deep. So what happened? He pushes him in the deep end of the pool, means other end of the pool, which was 9 feet. Getting my point? Which was 9 feet. So he reached at which area? At the other end of the pool, which was 9 feet deep. Okay. He reaches 9 feet into the water and starts struggling desperately to hold on to something because he would like to come up. Okay, he was frightened over there. Okay, he was frightened, but still his wits were working. He thought that on the way down, he planned when his foot would hit the bottom, then he would make a jump and come to the surface. He was planning, but students, it seemed a long way down. Moreover, he yells for help, but starts feeling paralyzed, and only his heart was moving now. Thus, he finally, what happened? He tried, but finally, what happened? He gives up and readies himself to die, but wakes up at the side of the pool. He readies himself to die. Why? Why he readies himself to die? Because he would like to cease all his efforts, because his efforts were in vain. His efforts were in vain. He sucked for air. He was swallowing water. Usko kuch bhi nahi mil raha. How much he was doing, how much he was putting his efforts, he was not getting anything. And then what happened? Then he lost in oblivion. He crossed to oblivion and he felt that the curtain of life fell. He felt that the curtain of life fell. Okay, life fell. Okay. Then after some time, when he came in conscious, he wakes up at the side of the pool. However, the terror he experiences while drowning never goes away, because that terror was icy horror. Okay, it continues to haunt him for many years and even spoiled his future expeditions concerning canoeing, swimming, fishing and more. Actually, what happened after this incident of 10 or 11 years old, when William Douglas would like to go anywhere, any water activities, the horror, the terror, the icy horror came back and it started haunting him. He even visits, then he tried to go different places. He even visits Marine Lakes, Columbia, New Hampshire and more, but he is not able to enjoy it. Wherever he went, the haunting fear followed him. Okay, the haunting fear followed him. So thus, he decides to overcome his fear by hook or by crook, because he did not want to die in fear. Okay, he enrolls himself in a swimming class and tries to learn from the instructor. The instructor teaches him many tips and tricks for swimming. Okay, he begins with the inhaling. Means instructor taught him how to inhale, how to exhale into the water. Okay, next he held him at the side of the pool. Instructor held him at the side of the pool and taught him how to kick legs in the water. Okay, and then he practices it for many weeks. Further, he moves on to the kicking the legs on the side of the pool. Finally, he combines all this with the final move of swimming. Students, you have to note one point over here. Instructor started in the month of October, and in the month of April, means October, November, December, January, February, March, means after 7 months, instructor combined all the tips with the final move of swimming. Although the author knows how to swim, he is still terrified of water. Thus, the author knows how to swim. He is still terrified of water. Okay, because actually the problem is what? The icy horror that grabbed his mind, heart, and spirit. Thus, in order to get rid of the fear, he decides to confront it. He mocks it by thinking, what can it really do? Okay. And wherever he went inside the pool, what happened? The terror returned. But finally, in the warm lake, okay, the terror did not return. Consequently, he plunges into water and to his surprise, his fear goes away. Means he tried all his level best. He went to New Hampshire again. He dived off a dog at Trigger's Island, means different rivers, different lakes. He tried everywhere and finally his fear goes away. He faced it in many places and at last manages to conquer it. At last he told, what? The experience had a deep meaning for me. Which experience? Of learning swimming and fear, he has conveyed as only those who have known stark terror, jisko dar hai aur wo dar ko jab conquer karta hai, it can appreciate. Everybody will not understand what was my pain and how did I conquer it. In that there is peace. So he recalled the sentence of famous statement of President Roosevelt, all we have to fear is fear
itself. Okay? Okay, because what happened? Until we face the fear, it is fear. Okay, and when you will face it, then you will finally conquer it. So conclusion of the deep water chapter is, to sum up deep water summary, we learn that if we are determined enough and have the courage, we can overcome any fear that comes our way without letting the fear overpower us. Yes, it is right. Means if we are determined, if you are determined enough to do anything you can do, you can achieve your target and have the courage, okay, have consistency is also required over there. We can overcome any fear that comes our way without letting the fear overpower us. So students, we have completed summary of the chapter. Okay, how William Douglas met two incidents in his life, okay, and what happened in the second incident. Then finally we have come to know how he used every way he knew to overcome his fear, and then in the month of October he decided to get an instructor and learn to swim, and then finally he shared his fear. At last he felt released, okay, and what did he do, उसने क्या किया, and he conquered what, his fear. Okay, so we have completed message of the chapter, deep water theme of the chapter. Students, please note this thing, you have to go through the theme and you have to learn it. Okay, and tomorrow we are going to start line by line explanation of the chapter deep water. Thank you, have a nice day.